Hello, Channel Fireball, and hello, YouTube. What's up? Ben Wernie, a.k.a. Mr. Metronome from the Lords of Limited podcast here, bringing you a Strixhaven Best of One draft video. Let's check out our opening pack here. Rare Radiant Scroll Wielder. This is 2 red, white, 2/4 instant and sorcery spells. You control have lifelink, and at the beginning of your upkeep, you get to exile a random instant or sorcery card at random from your graveyard that you get to cast that turn. This card is pretty busted, and I think a reason to draft red white and or is a really good splash in a Prismari deck. If that weren't in the pack, there's not great options. Rise of Extus is, I think, one of the better picks at common. I think I would take it ahead of Fractal Summoning at this point. Well, it's a very close pick, and I think, you know, depending on which road you want to go down, you could value one of those higher than the other. Past that, Study Break stands out, Cram Session, Pop Quiz, Scurried Colony, all fine cards, but I like starting off with the Radiant Scroll Wielder here. I think if you wanted to be conservative, you could take Rise, but this card is very powerful. I've had a chance to play with it, and it is a boatload of fun. All right, looking at this pack, things are already getting interesting. So there's good options. Master Symmetrist is fine to good, but again, doesn't match up with our Radiant Scroll Wielder, the 4/4 with Secret Reach. I've had so many people attack into this accidentally. Serpentine Curve is really good and plays super well with our Radiant Scroll Wielder and the type of deck we'd like to build with our Radiant Scroll Wielder. I don't love picking Serpentine Curve this highly in pack one, but there's sometimes you get this and this is all your deck wants and you'll pick it very highly. Past Serpentine Curve, Mage Duel is very good. Again, doesn't match up with our Radiant Scroll Wielder. And then we've got Inkling Summoning that does. And I think I'm going to be on Inkling Summoning here. We maybe end up Lorehold aggro. We maybe pivot into Silver Quill. Regardless, this is, I think, the avenue of best and most flexible that lines up well with our first pick. So love grabbing an Inkling Summoning here. Moving onwards. All right, now we get to take a Rise of Extus. So this is going, or should I say Extus? This is going swimmingly so far. We have a pretty clear route, although this is where drafts usually start to get rocky around pack one, pick four, pack one, pick five, if you get cut out of your college. So we'll have to see what the next packs bring, but Rise of Extus is great, and I think goes very well along with these two cards. This would be great top end to a Lorehold deck, or will be great in a Silver Quill deck. I think if we're heading towards white, which it seems like we might be, we certainly want to be leaning aggro. Hunt is good, still in the pack. Shadowwing Laureate is good. Shadewing Laureate, excuse me. Brackish Trudge, all good. So we're seeing some good black and or white cards. Still an Intro to Prophecy in the pack. We'd like to pick one of these up at some point, but not over Rise. And again, this is best card in the pack, I think, and most flexible card in the pack. So great for us. Oh, buddy. This pack is insane. So Professor of Symbology is nuts. One of the best three uncommons in the set, along with Igneous Inspiration and Divide by Zero. Thrilled to see that here. Bookworm also very late for this card. So there's a rare missing out of the pack, a Mystical Archive missing out of the pack, and a common missing out of the pack. That's kind of crazy. I can't believe somebody took a common over Professor Bookworm or Combat Professor. This is great news for us on the white life right now. So thrilled to see Professor here. If this weren't here, we would be taking Combat Professor, and we will ship Bookworm along to our neighbor. So Professor, welcome to the team. All right, so this is interesting. So stuff's still flowing here, and you've heard everybody sing the praises of environmental sciences about how busted this card is and all the things it does for you. I kind of don't want to pick it here, though, because I don't want to pass this Rise of Extus. I think I'm going to take Rise. This might be a gigantic mistake, and environmental sciences is great, but I think this is a little bit less important when you are the white aggro deck, and it's looking like where we're going to be, whether it ends up being Silver Quill or Lorehold, and we would want a copy of this, but I just can't bring myself to pass Rise of Extus. So I'm going to take it here. And then we've got three premium learn cards, and we'd like to pick this up. But when you're white, I think Inkling Summoning and Expanded Anatomy are more important than environmental sciences. All right, we are getting hooked up. Holy cow, this is nuts. I promise I didn't cherry pick this draft. I have no time for that. It's about like 8 o'clock at night here. Actually, it's 9:30 at night. I just got home from school. So welcome to the life of a teacher. Guiding Voice, and I think we're going to take that over Arrogant Poet. I don't even know. Arrogant Poet's such a premium too, but I don't want to commit to Silverquill because we could just very easily be Lorehold aggro here or Lorehold Control. And I would like a third rise, I think we want to vary our CMC here a little bit. So taking Guiding Voice and unfortunately sending some good black signals, but we've done a pretty good job of cutting things so far. And normally, I think you want to be in the position of reading signals rather than trying to send signals, but we've just been getting such clear white stuff that we're kind of reading signals and cutting at the same time. But generally, what's coming from the right is way more important in this format than the signals that you're sending to the left, in my experience. And as far as the format goes, just in general, I suppose, while the packs are slowing down here, we're going to take Spirit Summoning over Stonebound Mentor. This is not a premium lesson, but we have enough learn already that I really want to make sure we end up with enough lessons. And this lets us hashtag delay the decision for whether we're going to be Lorehold or Silverquill, because we are certain to be one of those two at this point, I think, barring some crazy disaster. Okay, this is interesting. We could take an Unwilling Ingredient, we could take a Plum. This is more of a Wither Bloom card, I think, than anything else. This is a Silver Quill card, I think almost more than it is a Wither Bloom card in some respects. Whereas +1/+1 counters really well. I'm going to take this mostly because I think Lorehold Excavation is real bad. But maybe I should take it because my neighbors might think this is a signal. I don't know. I guess maybe there's a world with Radiant Scroll Wielder that we want to get things in our graveyard. I doubt it, though. It's pretty rough, I think, when you're trying to do anything graveyard synergy. I'm going to tentatively put that in the sideboard. This is a great wheel for us. Study Break is a primo learn card. And again, this is one of the smoothest starts I've had to a draft. So I don't know that you're learning a ton here. But so while we're drafting, I think if you're drafting the format, if you're white, you really want to be Lorehold or Silverquill aggro. Generally Silverquill, but Lorehold is fine as well, certainly if you get the red cards. And then if you're not that, you're trying to be either Prismari or Quandrix, and then Witherbloom is just kind of this awkward thing off to the side. What do we want here? There's no way we're going to be playing a Beaming Defiance, I don't think, with as good of the cards we have already. So I think I'm going to take Fuming Effigy here, just as a 4-drop beater. We have some Guiding Voices. Maybe we just keep cutting white. We're not going to be hurting for 4-drops, and maybe there's a world where we want to be hyper aggro with Star People. Who knows? Oh, wow. Okay, so Shadewing Laureate Wheeling is like a, hey, you should be Silver Quill type signal. This is crazy. Was this the pack that had Combat Professor in her? Is that pack still coming up? Would be insane if we wheeled Combat Professor, but thrilled to see Shadewing Laureate here, and I will go back to the other view because I know it's hard to see in that view sometimes. Wow, this is a late arcane subtraction. This should not be going this late. Learn cards are at a premium. With where we're at right now, I think I want to lock up my one Silver Quill campus more than I want a 2-drop in Blood Age camp, Blood Age General, that is. Okay, all good options here. I think I'm going to cut. There's no world we're going to play first day of class, even if we end up red-white, because we have so many good learn cards already, I think. So I'm going to cut the Silver Quill card here. And again, I'm going to cut a Silver Quill campus, even though I'm unlikely to play two of them. Stonebound Mentor could make the cut if we end up red-white. We also theoretically will probably still maybe want to try to splash this Radiant Scroll Wielder. Okay. Not the most exciting pack in the world here, pack 2, pick 1. But pack 1 was insane for us. We're going to take Silver Quill Pledge Mage here. 3-1 Magecraft, you can give it your choice of flying or lifelink. And there's also Intro to Annihilation. We would like exactly one of these, but I don't think I'm willing to take it over Pledge Mage right now. And then Pillar Drop Rescuer would be a fine wheel. Also nice synergy potentially between the Pledge Mage and the Shadewing Laureate. So let's get this in here. Biblioplex Assistant potentially on the wheel as well with double rise could be good. Ooh, baby. All right, so we've got Killian here as a Nutter Butters card. White, black, 2/2 lifelink menace. Spells you cast that target a creature cost 2 less to cast. That's real good with double rise of X2s here. It's also Dramatic Finale, which is borderline broken. 4 mana, Silver Quill Hybrid. Creature tokens you control get +1/+1. And whenever one or more non-token creatures you control die, make it 2/1 inkling. I don't know what's right here. Like, intellectually, I think this is a bomb, but my heart says Killian's better with what we have going on here. We wield the Shadewing Laureate. I'm going to take dramatic finale. I don't know if that's right or not, though. It's really close, I think. Yeah, already getting punished with another 4-drop. I should have taken Killian. Oh, well. We will live and learn. I think we take Combat Professor now over Expanded Anatomy, but we really would want both of those. That was tough. Yeah, I think we are in need of creatures and 2-drops enough as well, and it made the 2 rises cheaper. I don't know. Very difficult decision. But Combat Professor is primo here, and we would like an Expanded Anatomy, but we're not taking Expanded Anatomy over Combat Professor. This is the best white common, not particularly close in my opinion. All right, so now we have a choice of, this is where it gets interesting. That was part of the reason I talked myself into dramatic finale, is like, there's a world where maybe we end up Lorehold still. Like, Venerable Warsinger's great. There's also just a Leech Fanatic as a premium 2 here for Silver Quill and a Spiteful Squad. It's clear that white aggro is open. What do we want most, though? My gut says we kind of just want the 2 in Leech Fanatic the most, more than we want Venerable Warsinger. I think I'm going to take Leech Fanatic and try to wheel the Spiteful Squad, because we really, really, really need a curve. This is going to wear +1/+1 counter as well, etc. It's going to incentivize trades with Dramatic Finale. Ooh, another Combat Professor. Yes, please. There's also a Lorehold Pledge Mage. Those would be fine 3-drops, but again, I think we want to fill out the bottom of our curve when we get a chance to. And I'm really regretting this Dramatic Finale pick, which is an awkward pick to be regretting, but I think that was wrong. I think I was supposed to take Killian there, and I think I felt the pressure of needing to take the bomb in the video. I think if I were drafting by myself, I would have passed Finale and taken Killian, but I heard the YouTube comments in my head, and now I'm going to be getting YouTube comments about, why'd you take Dramatic Finale? You should have taken Killian, but... can't make everyone happy. If I've learned anything as a band director and a teacher, it is that you cannot make everyone happy. Combat Professor in. Ooh, never mind. We chose correctly. That was also how I talked myself into Dramatic Finale, was that Silver Quill felt open enough that we might get another Killian. So, I don't know. Never punished, maybe? Hashtag never punished. So Killian's great here. We would also love Reflective Golem or Pilgrim of the Ages, but this is... disgustingly late for Killian. Yeah, sweet draft, and I think we are likely to crush some people in the queues. All right, interesting choice here between Eager First Year and Spirit Summoning. Where are we at on lessons right now? We just have Inkling Summoning and Spirit Summoning at the moment. I don't think we want another Spirit Summoning, though. I'm after more of the colorless lessons at this point or more Inkling Summoning. So I'm going to take Eager First Year here. I think this is just a premium 2-drop in the format. It's white, and all of the white decks want to be aggressive. So Eager First Year over a hard-to-cast Lorehold Pledge Mage for me. And again, I think another Eager First Year over Pillar Drop Rescuer. There's another Pillar Drop Rescuer that we might be wheeling also. So I like the Eager First Year also for that reason. Let's get it in here. All right, and we did wield the Pillar Drop Rescuer. We also wield the Lorehold Apprentice, but we are Silver Quill, and nothing is going to move us off that at this point. So Pillar Drop, get in. And I do think, you know, despite this draft being fairly straightforward, we did leave ourselves quite a bit of time to choose between Silver Quill and Lorehold, and I feel like we landed on the right spot. Oh my good God. Really? Hashtag never punished. All right. Yeah, so we're the only Silver Quill drafter, and our deck is going to be bananas. Let's go. Nothing here. We'll cut the white card, and we'll ship some red, or maybe, I don't even know. It doesn't matter. Let's take a Pledge Mage. Maybe this will make the cut, maybe it won't. I'm going to tentatively put it in the sideboard. We wield a pilgrim. That is also insanely good. I think that's better than Star Pupil. Oh my good God. I swear to you all, this is the first video I recorded. I promise. So we have to take Elite Spellbinder here, but it stinks that we're passing Expanded Anatomy. But yeah, this card is nuts. Paolo Vitor Dama de Rosa in the flesh, PVDDR, on Elite Spellbinder. I've not gotten a chance to play with this yet, but I've had it cast against me several times, and it is primo. Would be thrilled to wheel Expanded Anatomy in Magical Christmas Land, but I doubt that happens. Might wheel Rise, though, with as open as Silver Quill is. So let's get Elite Spellbinder in here. Oop. All right. Again, another Spirit Summoning. Maybe that wheels. If it does, we'll take it on the wheel, but we're not that desperate for lessons that we want a second one of these. I think we're going to take Baleful Mastery as a primo removal spell here. This is just insane with Killian, right? It's just actual 2-mana exile creature planeswalker, just better than Doomblade. So yeah, we're going to take that. Hope to wheel Spirit Summoning, I think. All right. This is an interesting pick. So lots of good options here in Intro, Poet, Reduce less so. I'm more interested in Introduction to Prophecy than I am Reduce to Memory, Brackish Trudge, and Rise. I kind of think our curve wants Arrogant Poet, but I also kind of think Arrogant Poet might wheel if we wield Killian. I think I'm going to take a lesson here because we have so much good learn. We have, well, do we have that much? We have 1, 2, 3. We actually just loaded up on all that learn early, but I still think we want this. And then we're going to wheel a playable, probably an Arrogant Poet. Okay, this is going to the sideboard. And Necrotic Fumes is a nice pickup here. This is not something we really, really need, but this kind of does an impression of Introduction to Annihilation. And if we get any Hunt for Specimens, we'll go up in value quite a bit. Late for a Barian Books. I'm just kind of trying to get a sense of our curve here. I know I keep going back to that view. I'm sorry. Divine Gambit would be a very good wheel. And I think it's not unreasonable to expect that to wheel either. So let's get Necrotic Fumes in the sideboard. For as open as Silver Quill is, we are not particularly getting hooked up here. I think we're going to take a Reduce to Memory, but again, not ideal, but I think it's still better than Expel. So good thing that we got hooked up in pack one and pack two. Put Reduce to Memory in the board. Yeah, we just so we got some unlucky pack opens there. We are still the only Silver Quill drafter confirmed. Silver Quill Command is pretty nuts. 4 mana, choose 2. Creature gets +3/+3 in flying. You return a creature card, mana value 2 or less from your graveyard to the battlefield. Imagine doing that with Killian or Professor. And then also you can make someone sacrifice a creature and a player, draw a card, lose a life. Inkling Summoning is excellent here. I think that's more important than Alan Shieldmage. I like Alan Shieldmage a lot, but the second Inkling Summoning is very good. And then we really want to wheel. There's a Pillar Drop we could wheel. I mean, this is good, but I don't think it's as good as Inkling Summoning. It's kind of a bummer for our last pack. So we're going to barely get there on playables, quote unquote, but 14 creatures. Maybe we actually play a Beaming Defiance. I don't hate that with 2 Killians that we want to protect. We actually have quite a few premium cards that we want to protect. I think that's more important than Crushing Disappointment. We have enough Learned Lesson that we have card advantage that way. Ooh, we wield Expanded Anatomy. That is Chef's Kiss. Straight to the sideboard here. Loving it. I think our deck is just bonkers now. After having picked up a second Inkling Summoning and Expanded Anatomy, I think I want the Eager First Year here. And we are not going to try to splash Radiant Scroll Wielder. Our deck is about a 10 out of 10. So another 2-drop here is excellent. Wow. We just wheeled it all. So we really got some unlucky packs here after this pack because we're not going to wheel much else, but this is wide open. I think I want the third Rise more than I want Arrogant Poet, which might be wrong, but I can't pass up triple Rise with double Killian. This card's so good. And also, I think lets us compete really well into the late game. I think it's more likely that we want a Stone Rise Spirit than that we want a Professor's Warning. I don't even know if that's true, but I think it is. Star people to the board. Elocution. I don't know. Maybe there's no world where we're even going to be able to cast that. Okay. That was bonkers. And hopefully we can come through in the gameplay. So, let's build our deck here. I think Star People is not making the cut. And then we probably want one more cut and just want to run 17 lands. Let's see, this is 15 creatures here. Stonerise Spirit is cuttable. I guess Stonerise Spirit is cuttable? I don't think anything else is particularly. I guess Beaming Defiance maybe is. But I think I like that better than Stonerise Spirit. That's still, if we cut Stonerise Spirit, that still loses 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2 drops. And a lot of good 3 drops. So I think I like this in 17 lands. And I think we will run one campus. And then suggest some lands here. So does that seem right? Apparently we're way whiter than we are black. But we don't really have double white or double black anywhere. I guess this is fine. Yeah, seems good. And then maybe we want... Do we want two campus? We're not particularly aggressive. I think I'm actually going to run two campus. Because it feels like one of the only ways we lose is missing a color. And I think we can afford the tapped land and still come back from that. Normally, I think I'd only like one land and one tap land in an aggressive deck. But all right, primo lesson suite here. This is juicy. And then there's also reduced memory, and we're going to take a quick screenshot here. And then I'm going to make sure I remember to take the lessons out after we screenshot. And that is it. We will see you for the gameplay. That was sweet. All right, we're here for round one with a stacked hand. This is a pretty clear keep. We're playing in diamond or platinum right now. We're one win away from diamond, and I have not been able to play as much magic as I would have liked this month. Beginning of the month was all sealed for the arena open, so I am working my way back to mythic, and we'll get there. But unable to record this video at mythic for you, so sorry about that. But good to get some platinum and diamond gameplay as well, I think. All right, so we're going to go land Killian here. Feeling pressure to 7x with this deck after how beautifully that draft went. All right, this is all good. So let's go land Pilgrim, get a Plains. And then I assume we will stick Dramatic Finale next turn. Wow, rude. Wonder if they would have, they would have shocked if I had attacked first. All right, Plains acquired. It's okay, we got another Killian waiting in the wings. Is this like Cody with a skin? What's going on over here? That's a very classy looking Cody. All right, what do we want to do? I think I honestly just want to play Dramatic Finale. It feels, well, I wonder if they have a counter spell. Huh, maybe we play a Combat Professor? I don't want to trade with Prismari Pledge Mage, though. I'm going to play Dramatic Finale. Please don't have Negate. All right. That feels like game over. Maybe it's a bit premature to declare that, but... difficult to see what the opponent could do there. Spectacle Mage, sure. And then I think this turn we play Combat Prof and jam with the Pilgrim. Oh, well, or not. So now, what do we do? I think I just want to play Killian and Eager first year, and then next turn we can play Combat Professor. That feels right to me. And then we'll also have removal up. So we'll take a hit for four in the air, but I think that's fine. And we're going to be putting some serious pressure on the opponent after playing Combat Professor. And if we don't feel like we have an attack with Killian or things like that, oh, X equals four, huh? That was impressive. I was thinking the opponent was about out of steam, but apparently not. Okay. That is real good with Killian. So, what do we want to do here? We could command. We could push a lot of damage with command if we gave something plus three in flying and made our opponent sack a creature. And then we're pumping something, and then we also could Baleful Mastery something. That's kind of nuts. Seems pretty good to do that. That buffers our life total quite a bit. So this and this. +3/+3 in flying. Interesting. And then I don't even think we need to Baleful Mastery. I think we just jam here and that's enough. Seems pretty good. And then we pass. I'm just trying to think how we lose because our cards are so insane right now. First day of class. Okay. All good. They're going to go get an elemental summoning, maybe? 5/5 haste. Expanded anatomy, okay. And a maelstrom muse. Sure. I think I kind of just want to kill that. Do this, target you. Get Shrek'd. Is all fine. And then I think we. Do we rise? Do we combat professor? I don't even know what we do. We're winning so hard here. I think we combat professor and then we rise after they expanded anatomy. So let's pump the pilgrim since Killian definitely gets in. Attack like this. I probably could be jamming with the eager first year as well. This might be the best deck I've played with all format. Taking that dramatic finale and wheeling Killian was ridiculous. All right. Attacking. Bold choice. No blocks. Cast Rise, Exile, Ingenious Mastery. They have a counterspell? Test of Talents would be kind of sad. Okay, there we go. We got the concession. See you for round two. All right, we're here for round two, sitting at 1-0, and this is not the world's best hand, but it's a keep. Got a lot of good draws in the deck, and we're on the play, so even if we brick on a 2 or a 3 drop, Combat Professor should be pretty good. These are the hands that are dangerous to keep in best of one, though. Blood Age General. Okay, there we go. 3 drop acquired. We won't trade with Blood Age General. Pilgrim of the Ages, sure. No blocks. This is where that hand, I think, would be a lot harder to keep if we're on the draw. Because the fact that we are essentially keeping pace with our opponent despite not playing anything till turn 3 is just huge. Next turn, we'll have Guiding Voice into Inkling Summoning, or probably Inkling Summoning, honestly. Whoa, that's terrifying. Ruh-roh, Raggy. No blocks. Huh. That really needs to die, but I don't want to turn it into a 3-2. I probably have to, though, right? So let's Guiding Voice here. I don't think we can let that live in good faith. What happens if I play an Inkling Summoning? Just nothing good, right? Yeah, I think I have to reduce that to memory. Which is pretty rough to upgrade the power of our opponent's creature, but... I think we need to do that. The card is absurd. No attacks. And then hopefully Rise of Exduce can stabilize us. If our opponent has removal here, we're just in huge trouble. Wow. All right. Best of one, ladies and gentlemen. Wait. Why didn't they attack with Blood Age? Oh, they want to pump. So I have to block. Those are both spirits, so we block here. It's not great. And then take 8. I don't think we can come back from that. So I tap out for Rise, and then we're just dead. Close. But I think we are, in fact, dead. All right, 1-1. See you for round 3. All right, we are on the play, doing our good job winning at die rolls. This is game 3. We're at 1-1, and good luck to Gold Mirror. They're deep in thought about which land drop to play first. Ooh, Mulligan. Oh, that's right. I'm on the play. Duh. I was like waiting for them to play a land. That is not what is happening here. So we're going to lead on, I think, Pledge Mage over Laureate. Let's see what our opponent ends up doing. Are they thinking about going to 5? That's pretty rough. Okay, they were just thinking about which card to put back. 2 drop here would be a great draw. Wouldn't mind a Killian. All right, that's also a good draw. Plays very well with Silverquill Pledge Mage. Needlethorn Drake. Okay. You're late, friend. So I think we play Pledge Mage here. Card is obnoxious. Sure. Killian. is good but awkward. What do we want to do? I think we just play Killian because the upside of hitting a land and getting to rise Needlethorn Drake is just huge. And I think we say no attacks. And even if they deal with Killian here, which they're highly incentivized to do, if we draw a land, we can still play Combat Professor and try to force the trade between Pledge Mage and Needlethorn Drake. No, no, leave it alone. Lands, hello. So we could Guiding Voice and Rummage. I don't love that, especially into open mana. I think we just play Shadewing Laureate and pass here. Presumably, if our opponent had a way to deal with Killian, they would have done so. This is where you need that environmental sciences that we passed. Eureka moment. That's a good one. I mean, this game is certainly going the Quandrix opponent's way right now. Like, we're not pressuring them. They're hitting land drops. But the thing is, our deck can compete into the late game pretty well. I think better than the average Silver Coil deck. Yeah, deal. Land? Land. Let's go. Okay, so I honestly kind of want to rise Needlethorn Drake here. Is that crazy? That's probably crazy. Just do this. Exile that. And I think we give the Pledge Mage lifelink. And just attack with it. And if they want to trade Needlethorn Drake with it, they can go nuts. What do we even want here? Kind of just want Inkling Summoning, I think. I don't have particularly strong feelings about anything. See if they want to trade Needlethorn Drake with that. I think that's ultimately good for us. We'll see. Maybe I'm being too conservative about not wanting to trade with that. Because if we get Shadewing Laureate to trade with it, then Killian starts pushing damage. I would buy that I'm being way too conservative here. I just am generally of the opinion that even against a Quandrix opponent right now, I just feel like if we go to the late game, my cards are going to be so much better than my opponents on average. They got four land, regrowing Eureka moment. Wow, they're going deep. So I think we rise Needlethorn Drake now and we push a lot of damage this turn. Let's get rid of regrowth. That makes me nervous. Glad we got rid of that Leyline Invocation. We want to go flying. I get to draw a card also. What a ridiculous card. So I kind of want reduce just as a get out of jail free card. I think we have plenty of pressure on the opponent right now. It's Hulk Smash. No blocks for you, Goldmere. What are they learning with that? Interesting that now they want to go learn. Are they getting like an elemental summoning, a fractal summoning? If my opponent's next turn, ooh, wait, what? You need a splash color. That makes me nervous. Are we about to get Magnum Opus'd? Elemental Masterpiece. White. Are we going to get approached? Oh, that would be such a feel bad way to lose this game. Oh, no. All right, race is on. How can we push maximum damage? Here. And here. On, I think, Killian, I guess. So we spread our power out. Lifelink. I think we want Expanded Anatomy. Pump you. Smash with all of you. All right. Hopefully we can pressure our opponent enough here to win and they don't have a Wrath. Eureka moment. So where is approach? Yikes. That's so fast. No more card draw, please. No more card draw, please. Okay, what is this? Burien Books? We just go to combat here, yeah. And I play, put that here, I think. Almost certainly getting buried, right? What do they have? I'm so scared. Am I gonna overextend into a Wrath? I'm supposed to play these cards, right? There are no Wraths, right? In blue and green, and they'd have to find another white. I'm gonna be so salty if my opponent draws a bunch of cards here at instant speed. Okay, they're scrying. They have another draw two plus approach mana? They have to draw three. That's drawing two. Still doesn't get you there. Come on. Like an opt or something? Okay. Hashtag not dead. Okay. All fine. Whew, I was stressed out there. All right, 2-1. We'll see you for round four. All right, we're doing a great job winning die rolls. So we're sitting at 2-1. This is round four, and we're going to keep. Got a nice little curve here. Drawing lands or spells is good. Assuming they aren't like more Rise of X juice, I guess. Eager first year's gas. Let's go. All right, more Rise of X juice. Eventually that will be good, I suppose. Let's bash. My opponent wants to trade their Arrogant Poet for this. They can go nuts. We have a Pillar Drop Rescuer in hand to incentivize that trade on our end. It's fine. We're going to play a Combat Professeur. This card's really good in the Silver Quill Mirror. So it just makes it so hard for your opponent to race. Arrogant Poet is fine. So I guess we just play Pillar Drop here. Well, let's attack first, like good Magic the Gathering players. No blocks and no way to remove this. It's an interesting turn. I wonder if they have like a study break on end step or something. No, huh. Wonder what their hand is then. Flunking my combat professor. Okay. I think we trade here. I feel like we are advantaged in a longer game. And here we just play Fnatic first year, and we've got Ryze locked and loaded for whatever they want to do. Combat professor of their own. That's nice. So we'll let this hit us and then push damage on the crackback. Oh, baby. I don't think we need to stick that. Well, it's awkward. We could just take a turn off. I don't think we need to do that. Combat professor needs to die. And we want to go get an Inkling Summoning, I think. And I think we smash. They probably trade with the Leech Fnatic. Would be my guess, but maybe they don't want to take damage. Okay, seems very good for us. Land would be a great draw so that we could Summoning plus Finale. Okay. They're getting their own summoning, sure. So I guess we get down Inkling Summoning here. And then next turn we can play the Dramatic Finale to pump it up. So let's ship. Resolves. And Argo. All right, this doesn't make ours enough bigger yet. Do I want to trade with that? I don't think so. I think we just play Dramatic Finale and pass. Do they have an instant speed removal spell? They don't have enough to return Pilgrim. Wow, they do. Okay. We got plenty of time here. We'll be awkward if we never get any Dramatic Finale triggers though. Wow, scrying, okay. Deal. Love seeing that, especially when they've got Pilgrim. I think the right play for our opponent, I mean, obviously we don't know their life, but if I were them, I would hope to draw action and then just rebuy Pilgrim if I bricked. Hits me. Spectre of the Fens, that's going to need to die. Study break. Still think we Ryze here. Get rid of their own Ryze. And I guess we get Inkling Summoning. We could get Spirit Summoning as a 4-3. I honestly don't hate that, actually. Let's get Spirit Summoning as a 4-3. Bring on the beats. We are on some amount of a clock here because of Access Tunnel. Dang it, opponent's drawing well. Okay. We're a bit behind the eight ball, but I still think we're in fine shape. No need to panic yet. So let's Spirit Summoning, and then we will probably Baleful Mastery Combat Professor, but I suppose we can see what they do here. They're scrying, sure. Scrying top. I don't like that. Please don't kill my 4-3. Sure. I guess I was not supposed to let them go to combat, huh? So do I study break now? Maybe we study break now. I kind of want to study break. And just make sure we can double spell next turn with Inkling and Baleful. That might be right anyway, honestly. What did they top? They topped something, right? Or no? Pilgrim, sure. This is not great. We need to draw out of this. I think we are disadvantaged at the moment. Can I get a creature, please? So let's attack. Maybe I'm not even supposed to attack. I think I need to try to kill my opponent, though. Play an Inkling Summoning and hold up Baleful Mastery, and we'll make sure that we don't let our opponent go to combat. I don't know where I need to put stops. I'm going to put the stops all of the places that we can put the stops. Swords. Okay. Resolves. All right, let's Baleful Mastery this combat professor. And we just can't stay back on defense with our opponent having access tunnel. But they've got infinite blocks with this pilgrim now if they want. Okay, they don't apparently, which makes sense. Okay, we're in trouble. Deck, please. All right, so now that we bricked there, we want to stop on our upkeep, I think. I have to keep attacking, though. I really think that is true. I don't think we are winning this game staying on defense. And then we are guaranteed to find action here. We have double scry locked and loaded. We've just like not played a creature since we cast Dramatic Finale 12 turns ago, yeah? That's game? Or puts us to one? Puts us to one, yeah? They get a double learn. They probably have an expanded anatomy or something to learn for. I don't know what else I was supposed to have done that game. Like, we definitely lost because we played Dramatic Finale as a dead card and didn't get any triggers off it, but it feels like we got a little unlucky for that to have been the case. Yeah, they got an expanded anatomy. Okay. Good beats. So we're sitting at what, 2-2 now with this deck? All right, pressure's on.
Need a way to re-spark the excitement in your TCG collection? Box breaks are the way to get your hands on cards from the games you love. Learn more today at cfbboxbreaks.com or check out CFB Box Breaks on YouTube.
All right, we're here for round five, sitting at 2-2. I was rethinking on that last game, and maybe I was too willing to trade off my Leech Fanatic. It's just so hard for me to fathom that we ran out of steam as hard as we did, but I think that could certainly have made our lives better had we not been willing to trade off the Leech Fanatic, but I just felt like we were so far ahead at that point. All right, this hand is Nutter Butters. And we've got land drops for days. Why is this island half blue and half green? Because it's a fractal? Is it a green fractal? Okay, there we go. How about that? Skrid Colony. So I think given that we have land drops at the moment, I would rather get Silverquill Pledge Mage down, and we're definitely offering the trade here with ye old Skrid Colony. This is looking to be a spicy brew. We've already got Silverquill Commons, Forest Island, Archway Commons out of our opponent. It's a yikes. But I think ultimately fine. Are they going to attack me for four? Cram session, so annoying. Okay. Elemental summoning. So what do we want to do here? Could make our opponent sacrifice a creature and draw a card. I think we just want to play Pillar Drop Rescuer though, TBH. I mean Pilgrim of the Ages. And then this guarantees us Rise of Exodus on time. I think we're fine to still attack here despite being slightly behind in the life total race. Find a trade Pilgrim off with either of these. Like, Pilgrim's kind of holding the fort down here. Killian. That's a good one. So what do we want to do then? Do we just Killian pass? That's kind of sad. I think we attack with Eager first here, because we're fine trading. And then we keep Pilgrim back on defense, because we kind of want to get a two drop in the yard for Pillar Drop. So let's go Killian pass. Then next turn we've got Rise and Silverquill Command up. No. All right, well, there's the two drop we're getting back with Silverquill Command. So we will probably choose the opponent sacks a creature mode and we rebuy a two drop. So let's go. Actually, we could just Pillar Drop it back. Huh. Nah, I think I'd rather Silverquill Command. So this and this. Choose you, Pikachu. Assume they're going to sacrifice Skrid Colony, but maybe not. We don't know their life. And then we're going to follow up with Leech Fanatic and say go. Wow, sacrificing the land is bold. Guess they already have Archway Commons for their blue mana. Witherbloom Pledge Mage is a big boy. So we Rise of Exodus, exiling, eliminate maybe? I don't think it particularly matters. My opponent is going to be in a world of hurt here. So what do we want to go get? Is it Inkling Summoning or is it Expanded Anatomy? I kind of like Expanded Anatomy on something like Leech Fanatic. Could also just get Intro to Prophecy. We don't really know what we need and we're fairly far ahead. I kind of like Intro to Prophecy actually to dig for future. This still gives us an attack with Eager first year. To dig for future action. I think Eager first year is small enough potatoes at that point, this point, that we want to bottom that. Spellbinder is gas though. And then I think we jam here. We actually just jam team. And they're almost forced to double block Killian. And if they eat something else, I don't think we care. Kind of into this. And then we can pillar drop back one of those two. Drake is annoying. So now I think, oh, do they have another play? That was so aggressive. So let's Laureate. Look at their hand. See what's going on upstairs. Rude. Exile that. And smash. And then next turn we can pillar drop back Killian. No blocks. I think we're racing that just fine. Hello, beautiful. Well, now I think we just do this. Or do we pillar drop plus? Yeah, I think we just do this, honestly. I think we're winning so hard right now. I guess Killian represents future lifelinking. Pump you and then smash with these two. And if they block Shadewing Laureate, great. Then we're getting in with Elite Spellbinder. Let's kind of pick your poison here for the opponent. They scryed top, which is interesting. Curate. I don't know that I would have scryed that to the top myself. It depends on how many cheap spells they have in their deck. That definitely feels like they need to do something pretty impressive this turn right now. Pop quiz, okay. What are you going to learn? Intro to Annihilation. That is A-okay. So let's go land. Pump you. Peanut butter and jam. Play you, rebuy Killian, play Killian. And say go. Assume a concession is incoming here. Are they not dead? They're definitely dead. Okay, there we go. 3-2. All right, we're back for round six, sitting at 3-2 against Joe Cherries, and we're going to keep. Leading on the old tapped land, and I assume we will lead on Killian, because Killian is nutso. And even if they kill Killian, they always have it every time. We have the Pillar Drop Rescuer to rebuy Killian at a later date. Ooh, that's a card. So I still think we want to slow roll that and get down Leech Fanatic. And the next turn we'll double spell on the Professor and the Eager First Year. Because it feels like if we can get in lifelink hits, getting in lifelink hits is pretty good. Wow, no play there is kind of insane from the opponent. So let's smash. What are they up to? Do they have an expel? Study break? You go nuts, opponent. I wonder. Makes me nervous that they have a wrath. Oh well. Pillar drop and professor. I think we're going to get inkling summoning. Let me play a first year. If they have a wrath, good for them. I'm a little suspicious of a wrath right now, given they skipped their turn three. unnecessarily worried about a wrath. That 4-4 is kind of annoying, though. So let's pillar drop, rebuy Killian, and then we have Killian plus Rise next turn. No attacks. Guiding Voice, go nuts. Inkling Summoning, also fine. No other plays, please. More plays. Guiding Voice, oh wow. Opponent's going all in dealer. It's not going to work out well for them. Let's go Swamp, Killian, Rise of Xtus, get Shock out of here. What do I want? I honestly think I just want another intro to Prophecy. And then we just jam. The opponent is incredibly far behind now. I guess maybe I was supposed to get a removal spell there, because one big thing blanks us so hard. Oh, baby, let's go. Here. And let's Prophecy. See what we can see. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. This is what our deck's supposed to do. Pump you. I guess I should have, well, I don't know what I should have done. Steady Break, sure. Let's attack, attack. Opponent taking it on the chin. Inspiration, my professor. Okay. That's all fine. Dramatic Finale wins this game pretty hard here. Does that just win? That just wins, yeah. Don't even need Dramatic Finale. Boop. Boop. And smash. All right, got him. See you next round. All right, we're here at 4-2, back still against the wall with what looks to be a good, if not slightly dangerous hand with double Rise. Still winning those die rolls also. We're going to lead on the lifelinker over the first year. Please no Pledge Mage. Excellent. All right. Curving these into Dramatic Finale feels pretty good. Its opponent has some sort of instant speed interaction, or they are being super pro plays and going into full... That's fine. Why I kill that over Leech Fanatic? That was interesting. So we definitely Dramatic Finale now. Smash. I whiffed twice trying to click my Leech Fanatic. Speaking of pro plays. All right, now let's just hope we draw some other creatures out of the 14 or 15 creatures we have in our deck. Jeskai is the opponent. Sparring Regimen with no creature. Okay. And us having double Rise makes me feel fairly okay about that, more than I normally would anyway. Leech Fanatic's gonna go coast to coast here. Oh, they're gonna annihilate my Dramatic Finale. Ah, that's fine. Draws us a card. Lets us keep pushing damage with the Fanatic. I think all things considered, this is good for us. Action. Please, deck, come on. Not having a follow-up threat here is really annoying. Sure. So they took something that's better than a Kelpie guide. All right, that's fine. I think we just scry here and then plan to rise that. That's good. We want that on the tippity top. Because some turn down the road. Actually, honestly, I wonder if we're supposed to double spell. Nah, I think we just rise this. So rise you. Let's get Heated Debate out of here. And let's go get another threat, I think, in Inkling Summoning. Opponent looks to have a brew. That's annoying. I don't think it's actually that big of a problem, though. So we can do all three of these, yeah? So we play Pilgrim Professor Summoning. Action. Plains Professor. And I think we... do we go get? I think we want another Inkling Summoning, and then we plan to win in the air. This is kind of scary with Sparring Regimen, though. Huh. That's going to hurt quite a bit. We're at 30, though. Huh. I think I'm gonna double block one of these. And if my opponent has a trick, good for them. That means they're not killing my Inkling Summoning. That's bad. Okay. Question is, do they have a way to stop the Inkling Summoning Assault? That hurt. But now, well... That was just bad. Why did I do that? That was so bad. Because the one was tapped, and then we get to leverage our removal and hit the opponent for a bunch of damage. That was really bad on my part. I don't know why I did that, and or didn't see how bad that was before doing it. That was really terrible. I'm sorry, Twitch chat. Or you're not Twitch chat. YouTube, Channel Fireball YouTube supporters. Please forgive me. So I think we mastery here so that we can get down another Inkling Summoning. Do they have negate also? No. That was so bad. Shock. Okay. Another Inkling Summoning. Our clock just got considerably slower. If they have another removal spell for this Inkling Summoning, could get ugly. I might have just lost the game on that bad block. It's so unnecessary. We're so far ahead. Oof. Okay, Pillar Drop Rescuer is spicy. That rebuys Professor. All right, that's good. So what else do I have? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can also rise one of these and go get Expanded Anatomy. I think that's better. It makes our opponent have an answer next turn. So let's get Expanded Anatomy. Play that here. And smash. So let's find out if they've got interaction. No blocks from us, I think. I don't like that they have not conceded yet. Serpentine Curve, concede. Concede, Cedrus. Oh no, we're dead. Okay. Yeah, I lost the game that turn that I made the bad play. Imagine that. Well, it's not quite that clear cut. We might still be able to mize this out. Because we're going to have chump blocks. They can't go nuts. What do we get here? Intro to Prophecy. What are the permutations? So if they only have one thing back. I actually think we're gonna win. Let's see. If they swing out, I have to block two things. And they will have one thing back. Reduce doesn't do it though, because that leaves them a blocker. But Necrotic Fumes also does not do it. So they're going to be swinging at me potentially with all three. I will have four blockers. We have two lifelink creatures. I think I just want Intro to Prophecy. I don't think either of the removal spells really do what we want to do. Like, we could get Necrotic Fumes, and that makes it more likely that they're going to attack with all three, but I don't think we actually want them to attack with all three. I guess Necrotic Fumes makes it so that if we top deck a creature, we win? They can't do that. They have to swing all three, right? Or they're just in bad shape. Because otherwise we win unless they've got another play. Right. Oh no, because it untaps. Okay, sure. So we block with Professor. Hope they didn't draw. I didn't pay attention to whether they topped or bottom. I'm so stressed out about blowing that other play. All right, so we Prophecy here. See what that brings us. Rise wins it. Boom. We did not deserve to win this game. Get out of here. Doesn't matter. Boop. Does it matter? It does not, right? Take a Necrotic Fumes. And then we attack. They block, block. Yeah, they're dead here. Yeah? Definitely. So the Flyer gets in, and Killian or the Leech Fanatic gets in. Whew. Did not deserve to win that game. All right. Deck is good, though. Got bailed out by the deck. All right. So we are at 5-2. See you for the next round. Still winning die rolls. This, I swear to you, this is the most die rolls I've ever won in my entire life. This hand is good. We really need to hit our third land drop, but you can't mulligan this hand. Yeah, and we are against the almighty Nat. All right, land drop is huge. Eat your first year. Let's go. Ooh, maybe against the Sam Black Dimir deck? Spicy. So I think we Spellbinder here. Well, let's jam first. And then let's Spellbinder, see what's up over there. Wow. I guess I want multiple choice to cast two more, cost two more to cast. Curve is making a 2/2. Yeah. Let's slow down the old multiple choicing. Wow, opponent has quite the brew. So we pilgrim here and jam. Smash. So I assume they are going to curve into a 3/3. Expel. Okay. Deal. Ooh, that's a nice draw. So now we Professor. I think we're willing to trade off Pilgrim. Nah, I'm not willing to trade off Pilgrim. I take it back. They can jump here and gain a life if they want. Interesting that they have not chumped with that 1/1 yet. I would have been tempted to do it there. I guess it's still going to be available at any time, most likely. Gross. Ooh, that feels filthy. Man, Combat Professor is illegal. What a card. What a card. So opponent needs some severe removal action here. And I get to choose if they bounce a creature. Yeah, they're so far behind. Ooh, that's a good one. Also interesting. All right, so let's kill Cody so that we don't accidentally die to Cody. I honestly don't think I care about them copying Serpentine Curve, which is kind of crazy. Let's get Electrolyze out of here. And I think we want Expanded Anatomy, right? Because that makes either one of our Combat Professors lethal next turn. Oh, I guess they already are both lethal. Maybe I should have grabbed Inkling Summoning then? I don't think it particularly matters. All right, 6-2. Can we go from 2-2 to 7-2? We dodged a bullet with some poor play last round. That was a pretty thorough smashing. So let's see what we can do. All right, we're back for round 9, hashtag max value. And opponents deciding whether or not they want to play. We finally lost the die roll. And this is a good hand, assuming Killian lives. If Killian dies, this is a bit more suspect of a hand, but you can't mulligan this hand. Ooh, opponent mulliganed. I like it. Silverquill Campus. Against Prismari. Ooh, Professor. We still lead on Killian here, yeah? It stinks if they have shock or whatever, but I don't think you can not play Killian there. The upside is just so large. Do we attack into Barry? I think so. That's fine. Professor into an Inkling Summoning? Biblioplexing back the Barry, okay. Drawing a land there was not ideal. Smash. It's a good trade for us, I think. We should, with double rise, just bury the opponent in card advantage. Pun not intended. With the bear. Whoa, what does that do? What is happening here? Plus one. Minus three to draw two. Yikers. That's a gigantic problem. Okay. No attacks. And they're going to get to ultimate this? Exile up to five target permanents? And just losing to Will? Wow. Maybe they'll tap out here. It feels difficult for them to lose if they just hold up Baryon Books. Please tap out. Oh, they're just not even risking it. Wow. Okay. Not good. Not good, not good, not good. Well, at least we drew a threat here. So they have to have another answer. I can't. This is only target creature. Yes. So let's pass. I guess I could have exiled my own thing to go get exile target nonland permanent. Is that the play? That was the play. Huh. Wait, what? Oh, they drew? Oh. And we drew this. Wow. What a strange turn of events. What am I supposed to do now? I feel great about my opponent choosing to draw three there. Can you imagine if they had plussed trying to ultimate and we top decked Baleful Mastery? That would have been so good. So I guess we just Baleful Mastery now and count our blessings. Let's do it like this. And then we're actually, I don't even feel like we're losing now, which is kind of crazy. So we play Killian and we play Rise on whatever creature they have. I do think I was, given that, I don't know. Like, what do I just lose if the opponent exiles five lands, right? Like, what else are we supposed to do? Is it non-land? Where is Will? Five target permanents. Like, if they just ult and make 5/4/4s, we're just done. All right, so play Killian, and we also have a Scry up, which is pretty nice. Yurgo opponent. Practical Research is good. Opponent's fairly far behind just in terms of tempo and board presence at this point, though. Especially if they're going to be tapping out for singularly large things. The worst thing for us is if they have removal. Whoa, it didn't pitch a spell. Okay. What does that mean? It resolves. Okay. Interesting. Bottom that, and I think Normally, I would not. I still don't like scrying on upkeep here. You just give up so much value by scrying on upkeep. Rude. Okay. Opponent has true control over there. I assume they have some serpentine curves. Multiple choice is gross. I think I want to get down first year and pledge mage. Well, yeah, I think I want to get down first year and pledge mage. I'm willing to give up my life total potentially to get some attacks in. Do not shock me again. I suppose they didn't shock me again. Opponent's deck is very good. All right, so we go land, Rise of Extus, and let's get rid of multiple choice. I still think that's probably better than Practical Research, and I think we want to go get Inkling Summoning here. Where's my other Inkling Summoning? I already cast it? I don't remember doing that. Hulk Smash. Berry, sure. Scrying to the top. Oof. God, that card is so good. All right, so again, I think we need, now I think we need to first year and rise. Our opponent definitely turned the beat around there. So many variant books. What do we want? It's a 4-4. I'm going to draw a first year. So if they attack me with the 4-4. I think I actually want Expanded Anatomy. It's high risk, high reward. Topping again. Don't love it. No blocks. So we gotta do it all, yeah? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. You have more interaction? Dang it. Okay. Do we trade here? How much faith do we have in our deck, having better late game than our opponents at this point? I think I'm willing to double block. Bottom that. This is tight. Guiding Voice. Ship it. I think all it takes is them finding a serpentine curve and we are deader than a doornail. I like that a lot. So let's pass. Because that makes us a lot less vulnerable to something like Serpentine Curve. And we get a rebuy Killian. Brainstorm, sure. I'm gonna be impressed if they have a way to shuffle. Hopefully they're just brainstorm locked. Kelpie guide resolves. We're full of action now, though. I think we're winning. So we scry. Dramatic finale goes on top, I think. We draw. Go to main. Play a dramatic finale. Play a silver quill command. This and this. We could get back Professor too. I actually think Professor is better at this point. Because that gets us another card with Intro to Prophecy. We could also just get... Still think... Oh, they're done! Boom! Got them. Whew, what a slog. All right, so from 2-2 into 7-2. That was sweet. And we got to play against some good opponents there, even though we were in Diamond for the video. So let's take a quick look at our busted deck before we go here. I seriously think this might... Maybe the three Rise felt like too many. I think for future reference, if I'm building Silver Quill decks, I think I would want two exactly. The opening hands where we had two Rise felt pretty awkward. We didn't draw Beaming Defiance much. All of this stuff was awesome sauce. I'm certain I made the wrong pick between Killian Dramatic Finale, but I am ultimately glad that we ended up with Dramatic Finale and a Killian in our deck. Pillar Drop was good, but this could go away. These were all awesome. These were all very good. So yeah, deck felt great. We had a great lesson suite. So I think we really, another good takeaway from that draft video was we punted egregiously when we double blocked the one elemental summoning. I do not know what I was thinking. Like, the correct play is to take the hit there and then use our removal spell on the untapped one to push damage. So thankfully we didn't get crazy punished by that, but that was definitely the wrong play. I do not know what came over me. So hope you enjoyed. If you made it this far, give me a little hashtag max value in the comment section. Let me know you made it all the way to the end for the 7-2. Hope you enjoyed. And again, if you're looking for more limited content, please check out my podcast, Lords of Limited. And when you check out at CFB for anything, use code metronome or code LOL, all caps, if you want to support the podcast. Thanks. And we'll see you next draft video.